Hey guys, Josh Mancuso here. Gonna do a little video about how to wash your gi. So here we go. First thing I do is where I keep my gear. I have a bunch of gis, and people are like, oh, why do you have so many gis? Well, I like them. And secondly, they don't get haggard. I can wear like one day, one another day, yada, 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 switch them out. And then, you know, I'm not that one guy on the mat with like that dingy, nasty ass looking gi. So anyways, I'm just gonna pick this gi, this OTM gi, stick it in my bag, and then I'll head to the gym.
Gotta get the gi nice and wet so you have something to wash, so let's kick some ass.
Gym, gonna take our gi and put it in the wash. I don't usually wash my belt. I do every now and then, but not going to today. Take all this stuff, walk over here to our washing machine. Gonna cold. I'm gonna steal the remainder of my wife's laundry detergent. I'm sure she'll be thrilled. Okay. Like I say, I put it on cold. That way it keeps the colors from fading. If this is the first time I'd wash this blue gi, I would not be washing it with white because it'll bleed on. But I've washed these a few times, so it's a non-issue. So here we go. That's the next step in the process.
Okay, at this point, I have taken the gi out of the washer, washed it on cold, and I hang dry my gis every time. Every time I hang dry them, I have a little fan that goes right here. I normally plug it up right there, and it just speeds up the drying process. But that's the way I dry them, because I don't like to machine dry, because it will shrink the ghee, and not only that, it will damage it, it'll tear up the sides. You know, you've seen tore up ghees before. Here's an example. I've got a corral right here, and I always machine dry this, and you know, you can see the damage to the collar, and this thing's been ripped multiple times, and the patches have started to fray, and that's all from, I personally think, from machine drying, so I don't recommend it. So that's how I dry it.
Okay, now that our gis are dry, what's going to happen is whenever you hang dry them like this, they tend to get really hard and kind of uncomfortable to wear, because they, I don't know, just have to hang dry, like this particular one, it'll probably stand up, you know, that's not comfortable to wear. Well, you get that when you hang dry as opposed to machine dry. But what I like to do, the trick that I use is do this. I just take the gi, follow me. We're gonna go put them in the dryer, but
we're just going to set the dryer to the fluff setting and start it up with no heat.
Okay, so I pull the geese out of the dryer on the fluff dry. As you can see, they were standing up on their own before. They're definitely not doing that anymore. Nice and soft to the touch. Just gonna take them right here. I'm gonna do a little fold job. Come over here. I'm just gonna go here. Nice little technique I learned to fold them. I actually stole this from a Hassan Mora YouTube video. Pretty simple. I'm just gonna fold the gi like a t-shirt. Inside. Pants are gonna go here. The top. Just gonna fold over. Just like that. I'm gonna take it over here.